Russian Defense Ministry said that mercenaries of the Wagner Group are completing the handover of their weapons to the Russian military. The move follows the private army's brief rebellion last month that challenged the Kremlin's authority. The disarming of Wagner appears to be an end to the mercenary group's operations on the battlefield in Ukraine. The actions come amid continued uncertainty about the fate of Wagner chief Yevgeny Prigozhin. The Defense Ministry said that among the weapons turned over were more than 2,000 pieces of equipment such as tanks, rocket launchers, heavy artillery and air defense systems, along with over 2,500 metric tons of munitions and more than 20,000 firearms. The statement follows the Kremlin's acknowledgement on Monday that Prigozhin and 34 of his top officers met with President Vladimir Putin on June 29, 5 days after the rebellion. Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov said that Wagner's commanders pledged loyalty to Putin and that they were ready to continue to fight for the motherland. Putin said that Wagner troops had to choose whether to sign contracts with the Defense Ministry, move to Belarus, or retire from service. The Kremlin's confirmation that Putin met with Prigozhin raised new questions about the deal that ended the rebellion. Putin denounced the revolt as an act of treason when it started and vowed harsh punishment for those who participated in it. But the criminal case against Prigozhin was dropped hours later as part of the deal. At the same time, the Wagner chief apparently could still face prosecution for financial wrongdoing or other charges. Belarusian President Alexander Lukashenko had brokered the deal that ended the mutiny. He said last week that his country offered Wagner field camps, but he noted that Prigozhin was in Russia and that his troops remained at their home camps. Lukashenko said that their deployment to Belarus would depend on decisions by Prigozhin and the Russian government.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.